Hello, everyone, and welcome to this FDI Insights series on Botswana, produced in association with the Botswana Investment and Trade Center, or BITC. I am today with Mr. Rajiva Chandra, the CEO of Sunita Cables, a manufacturer of copper wires and cables located in Botswana. Mr. Chandra, can you please introduce us to Sunita Cables?
We started Sunita Cables. We incorporated this company in the year 2000. Then we ordered machines, etc. We did market survey. And our first production run was in April 2003. We started very small, just with four workers and 600 square meters of covered space, which we took from BITC. It was called BD earlier. From that time onwards, we have grown almost 100 times in terms of sales revenue. Today we have more than 120 people working for us. We have more than 10,000 square meters of covered space. So the progress has been extremely satisfying.
Why did you locate your manufacturing facility in Botswana?
The main reason is that Botswana was encouraging setting up of manufacturing industry. And we realized that Botswana as a country is a safe country. The rule of law prevails. There is no political interference, but there is political stability in the country. There are no exchange controls, the financial stability in the system. So all these factors, they contributed to my decisions in setting up the factory in Botswana.
After setting up, did Botswana prove to be a conducive business environment for the growth of your company?
Oh yes, you can see from our record that we have, our revenues have grown 100 times from the time we started in 2003 up to here. And obviously, the environment has been very, very conducive to business growth. The market is small, but it's a very quality conscious market, and we made sure that our product meets all the standards, and we treated our customers very well with respect. So all these factors, they contributed to our growth.
What business opportunities do you see for Sunita Cables in Botswana in the foreseeable future?
Probably we have about 80% of the market share of Botswana. We also export to Namibia. So as far as the low tension cables are concerned, we have reached a fairly high level of market share. We need to now diversify in terms of product. We need to go into the solar cables, which is probably the future requirement. Plus we are also planning to set up a transformer manufacturing company, which will manufacture transformer not only for Botswana Power Corporation as well as for export. It's a related business, so I thought that's the right way to go about doing it.
Lastly, what piece of advice would you give to other investors interested in doing business in Botswana?
Botswana is a very quality conscious market, so you have to have the right kind of technology. The market is not very big because of the population. So you need to design your production system so that it matches with the market demands. You have to follow all the rules and regulations, which are not very rigid. They're quite flexible, but still the government insists that you follow all the rules and regulations properly. Don't look at the short-term business growth. If you look at it long-term, you will grow very well. That I can assure you.
Thank you, Mr. Chandra, and thanks everyone for watching. If you want to know more about Botswana, follow our FDI Insights series on fdiintelligence.com.